Tonight, Florida is in the clear, but parts of the Gulf Coast are scrambling to prepare.
The governor of Louisiana says more people may need to evacuate their homes tomorrow. Tropical storm Marco has not left much of a mark there, but Laura could prove to be more damaging.
And this is what it looked like earlier today in the Florida Keys. Rough surf, some rain, but thankfully no damage or serious flooding to report. The new advisory on Tropical Storm Laura is just in, and Chief Meteorologist Craig Setzer has it. Craig.
Yeah, and what we have tonight is not really good news, especially for the folks that are looking at us down here and Laura, of course, and seeing now a strengthening tropical storm. And the way we think it's strengthening is the pressure has started falling now. The pressure has a relationship to the wind. The lower the pressure, the higher the wind. And typically when the pressure starts falling, then the wind eventually starts coming up. So 65 mile an hour tropical storm with the pressure now down to 996. That's about a 5 millibar drop since about 8 p.m. this evening. West northwest at 20 on the motion, so still moving very, very quick. And you can see the tropical storm conditions mainly on the eastern side of it, but they are starting to now increase as the storm is starting to have activity wrap all the way around the center. Now, there are the latest warnings. Tropical storm warnings for much of Cuba, western Cuba, and still the tropical storm warnings for the lower Keys. Now the middle Keys have been dropped out of the tropical storm warning. Future track shows that by tomorrow morning, it's forecast to be a hurricane moving away from Florida. There's the extent of the tropical storm conditions going on into Tuesday, and then Wednesday forecast to intensify. Here's Wednesday morning. By Wednesday morning, the wind field's big enough that already along the coast, folks will be feeling the outskirts of the tropical storm conditions. And then as we go into Wednesday evening, it's going to begin to make a turn. Does it make a turn a little bit slower and head more towards Houston? Does it make a turn a little bit quicker and head more into central Louisiana? It's too early to call right now, but there's a lot of uncertainty, and a lot of folks up here are dealing with that uncertainty that we often talk about when we track tropical systems. This is the 8 p.m. Wednesday evening position. The hurricane force winds will likely be near the center. And this forecast value here is just shy of Category 3. So this is going to be at least upper end Category 2. Then it makes landfall, begins to weaken, and drop a lot of rain through the Mississippi Valley and then turn off to the northeast. Tonight, we're looking at some showers, quick-moving showers, so some gusty breezes along those showers. A bigger band of showers now moving through the Middle Keys. Wind gusts have been anywhere from about 30 to 50 miles an hour in these showers as we've gone through the evening. And even wider view here, you can see over the last 6 hours, there's the circulation in the center with Laura basically moving now out of the radar range of Key West on into the southeast Gulf of Mexico. Winds gusts, they've up 36 miles an hour this hour in Key West, 26 in Marathon, 26 in Pompano Beach. We saw wind gusts up to 69 miles an hour in a squall earlier today at the National Weather Service in Key West. Hurricane hunters have been investigating as we've gone through the evening there, both Air Force and NOAA planes. Keep an eye on it, and that's going to be important to help predict the track as we go forward into time. There's the latest satellite loop, and you can see kind of struggling because of all the land interaction there, but it likely to come back together because some of those thunderstorms now starting to wrap around the northern side. Marco's a tropical depression, so not dealing with that up there tonight. In terms of tropical storm Laura, the wind field is pretty close now to the Keys as we go through the night. It's basically going to stay there. And basically in the lower Keys, that's where we'll see skirting tropical storm conditions. Low wind there. The rest of South Florida, pretty windy with some gusts up to 50 miles an hour. More on our forecast. It's a return to summer. It's coming up.